Hello children, welcome to the next science class. In our fourth standard, we are learning about the life cycle of animals. Your lesson name is Life Cycle of Animals. What you meant by life cycle? The journey of one organism from the birth to the death, including the reproduction. That we can call it as life cycle. Suppose small baby, then the baby become little big and adult, completely matured adult, then again this adult will give another baby after the death. Now this baby, again just like a parent, just like a mother, they will start growing, right? This is called life cycle. Okay, birth, growth, again reproducing, after reproducing, the reproduced new young one again following the same ways, that is called life cycle. So life cycle of animals we are seeing, and already we have seen about birds, frog, butterfly. In the previous classes you learn how the birds life cycle is, how frog and butterfly life cycle from the baby turn to the last stage, adult stage. Now this is the last class of this lesson. With this lesson will get over. Here you are going to learn about parental care. Our aim is knowing what is parental care. What do you mean by parental care? How your parents are taking care of you? They provide a house for you, they are keeping you safe there, they give you food, they give you whatever you want. That is called parental care. So in all the animals, if you see, the parental care is very much good in the human being. But when you take animals, it differs. It depends upon the ability of the young one, because it's God's creature. When the young one, immediately after the birth, if it can lead its own life without depending the parent, then parent will never take care of such animals. But if the young one is very small and they cannot go take their food by themselves, and some other animals may eat them, may produce harm to them, they are very, very young and soft, in such case, sure that parents will take care. For example, see, we have seen already, birds will lay egg in the nest. So they build a nest and they feed. This is the parental care, right? They build a net, keeping the egg safe. And for sometimes the small nestling, small baby bird is taking rest there in the nest. And the mother go bring food and feed. So mother, birds show very good parental care. But you take both frog and butterfly, no parental care. Because frogs, immediately when the egg becomes the tadpole fish like structure, it can eat whatever small plants and microorganisms in the water. They need not go search to fight for something else. So the frog will never take care, it will go. Same way butterfly, after hatching, the egg, the larva which comes out of, from the egg, will eat the plant, the parts whichever surrounding there. So butterfly need not do anything, the mother butterfly. So there also no parental care. Now we will see some other animals also. Take your book, page number 40, we'll have a reading, and after that I'll go for the explanation. Keep your fingers as usual. Last paragraph, caring for the young. Some animals like birds take care of their young ones, but some animals like do not take care of their young ones. In the case of elephants, the entire herd cares for the baby elephant. The baby elephant is called a calf. Other elephants in the herd take turn to care the calf when mother goes away to graze. Kangaroos carry their babies in a large pocket on their stomach. This large pocket is called a pouch. Unlike elephant and kangaroos, rabbit babies do not need a lot of care. lizards, frogs and snakes do not take care of their young ones, as the young ones are able to take care of themselves just after being born. Crocodiles care for their young ones. So now we can see three types of parental care. First type is like birds, very good parental care. And second type like rabbit. In the case of rabbit, the baby rabbit depends mother only for feeding. The baby rabbit will feed, they will drink milk from the mother, rarely one or two times. Only that time they will come to the mother. After that they will go, they will live their own life. Like birds, they will not provide nest, they will not take care of their safety and all. So that is the second type. So this is very good parental care, this is normal. And third one, frog. Snake, no care. Frog, snakes, lizards and all, the young one have the ability to go eat by themselves immediately after the birth. So there is no need of parental care. Now, have you seen elephants and baby elephant? Yes, have you seen baby elephant? Nowadays it is easy to see, right? When you go to YouTube, whatever you want, you can see and you can understand very easily, right? Here, the elephant, baby elephants are taken care by the group of the elephants also. Whenever the mother elephant go for feeding, because the mother elephant has to feed the baby elephant, right? So that time they need more food, they will go for feeding. That time the other elephants in the group will take care of the baby elephant also. And have you seen gangroos? This also, you just in your YouTube go and check how the baby gangroos are taken care and how the baby elephants are taken care. You can see literally the gangroos will have a pouch. A pouch means what? A bag-like structure in the stomach. And immediately after the birth, the young gangroos will be inside the pouch for several days. Wherever it goes, the adult gangroos will carry their young ones and they will take care very, very, very nicely. Now, to understand better, you take your workbook sheets. You take your workbook and if you try to attend these questions, you can understand better. Page number 42 in your workbook, write today's date on top, S4. I'll read out the question. What is a baby gangroo called? How do gangroos take care of their young one? See, the baby gangroo is called Joy. What is that? Joy. And the young ones are kept inside the pouch and taken care. See, you have to understand the content and write by your own. Again, you wanted to understand again and again, listen the video, then you should write the answers with your own sentences. Second question, why do animals like cows and buffaloes sometimes attack us when we go near their young ones? You have to think by your own and write with your own experience. See, this cow, buffaloes and all, they will take care of their young ones very well. Just if you want the test, you know, when you go near any young one, when the mother is near that, for sure they will come to attack you. Why? The mother cow or buffalo will think that you are going to harm the young one. You are going to beat or do something wrong. So my child should not get any problem. Like that they will think and they will try to attack you. This you should write with your own sentences. Which animal babies need a lot of care? Why do they need so much? See this one. Again you must think and write. Do this froglets need more care? No, because the young one will have mouth and the entire surrounding food is available, easily they will eat. But you take like other animals like the dog, small dog, a very important human being, a newborn baby, even though you keep food near the baby, can the baby take the food and eat? No. So some animals like human being and dog, cats and all, they need more parental care. But some animals like even butterfly, after hatching the butterfly will fly. They will never come and see what happened to my egg, whether my egg becomes a big butterfly or not. That's all. It will lay so many eggs and will go. Whatever eggs are getting proper air, proper food from the leaf and without attacking from someone else, that escaped egg alone will become adult. No care at all. But in the case of birds or even other animals like cow and all, what will happen? Mostly the parents will try to give proper food, the proper safety place. Even if someone comes to attack, they will fight with them, they will send them, they will provide safety to the young one and they will make sure they grow well, right? So that you can write in your own words in simple sentences. Which animal babies need less care? How do they take care of themselves? So you can write about the tadpole, the larva, because they have the food surrounding immediately, so parents need not take care of them. Okay, so now this elephants and kangaroos are the best example for the best parents. They will take care in such a way, very very safe and very good food they will give. And if you take frog and butterfly, worst parents. We cannot say worst parent. Nature has given ability to the young one to feed by themselves, to take care by themselves. And one more thing is also there. If you take elephant, kangaroos and all, they will produce less number of young ones. Say less than 10, 4, 5, or sometimes 1 also. But in the case of frog and butterfly, you see, thousands of eggs will be laid by the frog and butterfly. So the even though they try to take care, that is not possible. So nature is living under the nature. The frog, the butterfly kind of animals will just reproduce and go. So the nature will take care of the young one. Whichever young one has the ability to fight with all the problems, they will become adult frog or adult butterfly. Those eggs which are not able to withstand, which are not able to get the food, this, that and all, they will die. That is the case. Now we have some animals like rabbit. Now in the case of rabbit, normal caring, that is, they will not leave just like frog and butterfly without taking care. They will feed their young one with milk 1 or 2 times or 3 times at the maximum per day. After that, there will be no connection between the mother rabbit and the baby rabbit. And when you take lizards, completely no care. Lizard also, just like the frogs, just like the butterflies, just they will lay the egg, they will leave it and go. So the eggs will develop and they will come out, the young one will come out from that. And the surrounding, whatever food available, they will eat. And the surrounding is not good, if someone is attacking, they will die. So there is no proper parental protection for them. Right? Fine children, with this, this class gets over. And Monday, you have your science test. I hope you would have studied. And today again, sit, read everything thoroughly. Already I have sent you 6 questions, sample questions I have sent you. And already I explained you, this time we are going to ask descriptive questions. You will not have one words, no fill in, no choose, nothing. We wanted to know how far you are listening our class, how you understood. So now I explain this now. Simply I will ask what is life cycle. For that you need not memorize and write. You have to write the baby stage wise growth. After particular stages over, in one point again it will reproduce and new one will form. Again this new one will go through the same steps, stages of the parent. So it is like a cycle, it is called life cycle. With your own sentences you write. And if you listen the class, if you feel that I don't understand this word, this sentence, see the video again and again. Then easily you will get. Don't read the sentence and memorize. Don't memorize things and don't try to write. Try to understand. Even the sentence formation is wrong, no problem. Write with your own sentence. Suppose, general question, I am giving you an example. How will I ask? If I ask, explain me about the best parental care with the help of some animals. Then you can write best parental care means after the birth, the mother must take care of the baby completely. They have to provide them enough safe place. They have to provide food. For example, birds, they will construct nest and they will go bring food and give it to the young ones. So they are example for best parent. And the elephant, kangaroos, they will carry the young one in the pouch. So it is example for best parent. You should write like this. See, children, understand. You should not memorize the question and answer pattern. From the explained content, if I ask any question, you have to pick the answer from this and write. Again, if I ask, say some lazy parents, that is parents which will not help the babies or the babies which will not depend the parent, then immediately you should say frog and butterfly. After hatching the egg, they will go. They will not take care. The frogs, from that, the tadpole will come out and it will go eat by themselves. And they are not depending upon the frog. That's all. So to write this, you need not get a question and answer. You need not sit memorize. You listen the class again and again. You read the textbook content again and again. Easily you will get the points. And you try to attend the worksheet. You will get clear picture. Finally, you can write the test without any mug up content. With your own answers, you can write beautifully. Right, children? So before the exam time, 10 minutes before, take pen, pencil and notes, everything, and you make sure everything is perfect. And sharply, when you get the question paper, start writing. After finishing, take copy and photo and send immediately. A very important thing, write with question and answer, write very neatly with eligible size letters and space everything. Okay, that's all for today, children. Let us meet in the next class. Thank you.